Good news does not always make the headlines, but looking back, the year 2021 had some moments to celebrate. Let's take a look. India started this year with its women making a remarkable achievement by flying the world's longest air route over the North Pole. The all-women pilot team of Air India departed from San Francisco to reach Bengaluru on January 9, 2021, covering a distance of about 16,000 kilometers. This is a challenging route and only the most seasoned pilots undertake this flight. Air India Captain Zoya Agarwal and her team thus created history. Indian women are flying high, quite literally, with 2,764 women pilots out of 17,726 pilots in the country. At 15%, the percentage of women pilots in India is the highest. Media reports said India has twice the number of women pilots compared to most Western countries, including Australia and the United States. Kerala became the first state where government schools introduced gender-neutral uniforms so that all students, girls or boys, could enjoy freedom of movement. The uniform was introduced in pre-primary and was immediately a big hit, which encouraged the authorities to extend it to all classes. In a first, the Karnataka police had decided to recruit 8 transgender police personnel, throwing open the doors for a community often marginalized and even shunned. The Karnataka Civil Services General Recruitment Rules 1977 was amended to give 1% reservation to transgenders. Earlier this year, in March, Chhattisgarh too recruited 13 transgenders in the police department. India ranks third in the world in organ transplantation, only behind USA and China, as per the data available on the Global Observatory on Donation and Transplantation website. Sharing the good news earlier this year, Health Minister Mansukh Mandavia had said, "It makes me immensely proud to share that the total number of organ transplants done per year in the country has increased from 4,990 in the year 2013 to 12,746 in the year 2019. In a little-known but major development this year, the clinical trial of an indigenously developed CAR T cell therapy for blood cancer treatment began at Mumbai's Tata Memorial Centre. This gene therapy technology was previously not available in India. If successful, it can save millions of lives by making this expensive treatment available at affordable cost in India. CAR T cell therapy is even known to cure some types of cancers. India, a 1.4 billion strong nation, reached the goal of vaccinating 1 billion of its population by October 24 this year after opening up vaccinations for elderly on March 1st and for those above 18 years from May 1st. That means 75% of India's massive population had received at least one dose of the COVID-19 vaccine by October 24th. Not only that, India on December 25th announced vaccinations for children between 15 and 18 years of age, as well as booster doses for the elderly and frontline workers.